Any hints on how to not always generate the model type? I want a normal person, not a supermodel. Not beautiful, not ugly, just an average face. Well, Isma, you're right that Midjourney likes to generate images that look like Photoshop supermodels. To generate photos that look more normal, we can use negative prompting. First, let's start with a prompt like portrait photo of an average American young woman, everyday life. A place where people might post their day-to-day photos would be Facebook, so let's also add that in there. Most importantly, we need the negative prompt accessed by using the --no parameter. Here, we'll write down all the stuff that we don't want to see in the generated image. Words like model, makeup, Photoshop, and perfect. I'll also use raw mode to minimize Midjourney's creativity. And now we can easily generate normal looking people that don't have the super photoshopped model look. I get asked a lot of questions like that in my comment section. I think a lot of them are common practical problems that you'll encounter when starting out with Midjourney. So let's walk through some of the solutions to the more common problems today. Hi, why does Midjourney produce distorted face, nose, or hand while generating images with multiple characters? I've tried a lot, but haven't been able to produce decent images with multiple characters. Please guide. Alright, so the smaller the size of the face relative to the rest of the image, the more distorted it'll be when Midjourney generates it. This is especially true if you're doing images with multiple faces. Take a close look at these hikers in the mountains. Their faces are totally warped and unrecognizable. One tip to try is using the creative upscale feature, which upscales your image, but also makes some subtle changes along the way to improve image quality. I find that most of the time, creative upscale fixes the distorted faces when you have multiple people in a photo. Take a look at the before and after, and it's night and day. The faces look way more human after upscaling. Although that hand is still kind of weirdly placed. Here's another example. Look at the girl on the right side of this image. Her face is really blurry and doesn't have the silhouette of a person. After using the creative upscale though, we can clearly recognize that it's a woman with glasses on. Hi, thanks. Could you please provide a prompt best suited for t-shirt mock-up photoshoot? Alright, so check this out. The Explore homepage on the Midjourney website features images that millions of other Midjourney users have generated. This is the best place to look for inspiration if you need specific prompts like mockups. In the top right, there's a prompt search bar. Let's search for shirt mockup. It looks like there's a ton of other people also generating t-shirt mockups. I really like this one that has a forest background in it. It looks very outdoorsy. When we hover over the image, there's this icon that shows a capital T inside a square, which is the edit prompt feature. Click on this to copy and paste the prompt into the prompt message bar at the top. I'll press enter to run the prompt and navigate to the create tab on the left, where we can see all of the t-shirt mockups being generated for us. I think any kind of outdoors hiking type of branding will look really great on these. Back to the original image. You can also use this search image feature that looks like a microscope, and Midjourney will find other user-generated images similar to it. Almost all of these have black t-shirts with some nature forest theme in the background. If you don't have access to all of the features of the new Midjourney website yet, you can always just copy and paste the prompt from the image and then use it in Discord. I think you should make a video on the insane new style reference and how complete brands can be created just from concepts now with style fluidity. I'm working on a portfolio showcasing how insane the potential is to show clients who could use full product lines created all in Midjourney. That's a great video idea. Let me test it out, how we can use a style consistency feature to create a complete product line. First, I'll need reference images. I'm going to head to pexels.com, but you can get these images from anywhere. Now, I want a rustic old school kind of vibe, so I'll search for rustic vibe in the search bar. Something like this photo of a countryside with a wooden cabin looks perfect. Let's download it. I finished collecting 5 images that I want my product line to be inspired by. They all have this countryside farm rustic kind of look. So let's head over to Midjourney and start generating our products. I'm in the Create tab here. I'm going to use the upload button, that's the plus icon, to upload reference photos. Let's just drag and drop our rustic vibe reference photos in here. And then we'll attach them into the prompt box. When we hover over the image, we see three different icons. The person icon is for character consistency. The paperclip is for style reference. And the photo is to use it as an image prompt. We'll be using the paperclip icon for style reference, and let's go ahead and do that for all five of the images. Now inside the prompt bar, I'll ask for something like product photography, a bar of white soap. There's a minimalistic rustic background. This should give us a product photo of a soap, but inspired by our five reference images. And the result definitely has that handcrafted outdoors rustic mood going on. I tried out some other products, like a bottle of perfume on a rock, this candle on a log, some winter boots. I like the pinecone decorations here. Notice how they all keep the same style and look, like they come from the exact same brand. Hey bro, hope you reply. My question is that all the things you're trying are basically normal and somewhere we've seen them. That's how it feels for every image. Here, what I want to know is that there's different groups of tribes. What I'll get on Midjourney is somewhat African and some other, but I want totally different culture, different tribe looks. Their looks should feel like the world haven't seen this type of tribes. Is Midjourney capable of generating these kinds of images? So you want Midjourney to generate something unique that we haven't seen before. If we just ask for a simple prompt like photo of an ancient tribe of people, Midjourney doesn't have enough information to create anything unique and will just give you a generic looking photo like this. We'll have to use our creativity and give Midjourney some more clues about what we want. Let's start with full body shot of a tribe of European people with blonde hair and light blue stripes of paint on their faces. Using our imagination, we can ask them to have yellow pupils in their eyes. Now it's already something unique. But I'll go even further and change up the clothing they're wearing to give them giant blue and yellow feathers. And finally, they should also have weapons made out of bones. I've never seen images of a tribe like this. It's definitely something that hasn't existed before. Bro, are you real or AI? Yes, I am. Please, can you create a tutorial on how to create images like the AI Historian or Stellar Sagas? I think you're talking about these AI history videos and shorts that have been going viral everywhere. If you want to figure out how to prompt for specific images you like, try using the describe command in Midjourney. Type /describe into the direct message, and then you can upload a reference image. I've taken some screenshots from Stellar Sagas AI history videos, which I'll upload here. I still have no idea how to use the describe command with the Midjourney website, so let me know if you figured that out. When you use this command, Midjourney generates four prompts that roughly describe the reference image you uploaded. These aren't supposed to generate that image exactly, but it should give you some hints. I'm going to hit imagine all to run all the prompts, and some of them look really similar to the original reference. We can go a step further and combine the describe feature with style reference. Here, I've described an image of Mongolian soldiers on horseback. I'm gonna copy one of these prompts and paste it into the prompt box. After that, I'll use the original image as a style reference. So right-click and copy the image link. And then inside the prompt, type --sref to use style reference and paste in that image link. And I'd say we ended up with a picture, pretty close to the original style. Quick question, for general PowerPoint background images generated by Midjourney, which general camera type, film stock, and camera lens do you recommend? That depends on what kind of PowerPoint you're trying to make. Adding the keyword stock photo at the start of your prompts will generate generic stock images that look like these. Nothing too fancy, but it'll get the job done just fine. Clip art gets you fun cartoon illustrations. These would fit in pretty well on some PowerPoint slides that's more lighthearted and relaxed. You can try vector illustrations and use a keyword minimalistic inside the prompt for these abstract but clean and simple designs. May I ask how to arrange multiple subjects in a scene? Yes, you may. For example, a girl is talking to a boy downstairs from a second floor balcony, with the girl positioned in the top right corner of the frame, and the boy in the bottom left corner. These subjects are not aligned on the same horizontal or vertical line. It's super hard to get that kind of fine-grained control in Midjourney using just a prompt box, so we'll have to try some other methods. Starting with this image of a building with a balcony I generated, I'm going to use the vary region tool in the bottom right. I'll select the part of the balcony where I want the girl to be that looks about right. Then inside the prompt, adding a young woman is looking over the balcony. With that girl generated, I'm going to use a vary region tool again, this time selecting the part of the street where I want the man to be generated. I'm actually going to delete the part of the prompt that talks about the young woman, because I don't want the man and woman to get mixed up by Midjourney. Next, I'll add a young man is standing in the street holding roses. He is next to the balcony. So I tried this a couple of different times. It's hard to get it to look very realistic. The faces are kind of distorted and warped. Remember earlier I mentioned that the smaller the faces are in the size of the entire image, the more distorted and warped they're going to be. Even the creative upscale can't fix these since the face is so small. Unfortunately, generating realistic small faces is still a huge issue in Midjourney. Please, make one video on Niji version. Don't worry, I have some anime prompt videos planned ahead. Here's a tip for now. When prompting for anime style, use strong emotions and expressions to upgrade your pictures. Images with powerful emotions capture the viewer's attention in the way that images without them just don't. Which one of these are you more likely to stop and look at? The one on the left with a blank expression, or the one on the right of the girl crying tears of joy? Take advantage of the expressiveness of anime, whether that's anger or complete fear. Add some storylines to your photos for the viewer to think about. This girl is terrified and running for her life from a demon wolf. Thanks a lot for your content. You're super welcome. Can you help me with the realistic texture of drenched clothes? I create some rainy scene and my subjects looks photorealistic, but hair and clothes are dry. Biggest challenge is also if you use different fabrics for a rain scene or a fight scene of warriors in a muddy landscape. Let's try to be extra specific in the prompts about the texture the clothing should have. I'll start with a photo of a Viking warrior running on the battlefield. I guess cloth would be a common material they used for clothing back then. Then I'll add that it's raining, and also say that his clothing is wet and covered with mud. His hair is also wet with water and mud. At the end, I'll use Kodak portrait film. So I asked for rain, but also specifically told Midjourney that the clothing is wet and muddy, and his hair is also wet and muddy. I'd say that these images look about right. You can definitely see the mud and water on his shirt. The hair also looks drenched with water. I also tried giving him chainmail armor, and the mud and water effects also look pretty good. It is true that Midjourney has trouble generating realistic water on hair and faces, but if you specifically prompt for it, the resulting photos will at least have the basic idea down, even if it doesn't look super realistic. Is it possible to have two or more consistent characters in different scenes? I've tried this using the prefer option set for two characters and with two character references at the end of the prompt and haven't had much luck. Well, Natalie, that's the most common question I've gotten. How to create multiple consistent characters? To answer that, I've created a video tutorial over here, so make sure to take a look if you're interested. Also, make sure you subscribe if you want to see more like this.